Hello, good morning. Hope everyone is doing well today. I am back. I took a mental health day yesterday. Had some crazy stuff happen over the weekend. For anyone who doesn't know me at any, like, IRL, there was a chemical fire near my house, so basically the whole city, downtown area, had to evacuate. So, that was hectic. But everything is okay now, we're all safe. Still kind of smoky out, so we're staying inside as much as we can. Oh yeah, so yesterday, because that whole fiasco was Saturday and Sunday. So yesterday, like, I was still hella anxious, so I was like, I cannot, like, pretend to be okay right now. But yeah, feeling much better today. Yeah, so we can go ahead and get started. No cam. Didn't dress up today, so... Yeah, so today plan is gonna be breaking out some India inks. Today, this is the only brand that I've been using. It is, oh, it's gonna be foot free, guys. It is Speedball Super Black India Ink. It is permanent, so it's really good if you're gonna do like line art and then do watercolor, because it's not water soluble. So once it's on the paper, it's on there. It's typically used for like calligraphy, typographies type stuff, which I have dabbled a little bit in. But yeah, so this is the rough I'm going to be using today. I think it's best if you're learning how to shade and stuff to print your references off in black and white. That way it's a lot easier to see like the different tones and shades. Yeah, the angle of my camera is going to be a bit off because I do work on a slant. Like, I have a binder here. I can lift up and down to get a better angle. So I know for me, I'm trying to work on style. Yeah, right now I'm just drawing guidelines. I haven't drawn people in a while. You can't see it on camera, but right now I just did a circle for the head, lined on the center. Typically, like proportion-wise, the nose is going to be one-third of the face, but because of the angle, her forehead looks larger in this reference. Like, see here. Or actually, it's just about right, never mind. Don't listen to me. Yeah, I gotta be careful not to knock these down, because it's right by my binder. The thing I liked about this reference was like the eye shape. Really pretty. I mean, like, I think the texture, like a way to illustrate the hair, will be really fun. Okay. I was debating whether or not to do like the grid technique, but then I was like, I don't want it to be a too accurate render. So whenever I draw, I usually go in with a regular, like a number 2, and then with finer details, I use my mechanical. Because with mechanical pencils, you can't get as good. To me, like, it's harder to fill in. Like, it's easier to use more pressure with a traditional HB or wooden pencil. Because you're more likely to, like, break the lead if you use a mechanical. And this reference is just a one I got from IG. I don't know who the model is, but she's really pretty, so... I'm actually gonna put it up against my monitor. I know for me, I'm trying to break away from outlines. But it's still so hard to, at times. The thing I need to get over personally is not getting too bothered if the ref doesn't look exactly like the rendering. That's something that's always bothered me.
Thank you.
This left hand is way too small when compared to this one. Sad. Another thing to note is the reason why you should grid if you're still learning is see how this first pinky lines up at like the top of the nose when my drawing is a solid like inch lower than it's supposed to be. Like this hand is pretty on point in terms of gridding. I could be a little bit lower. But this is a bit too low, so this needs to be higher. Cause see how this finger lines up at like the eye? Oh, you can't see it. The top two fingers line up just below the eye, so it needs to be translated up and then bigger. Morning, Skittles. How are we doing today? Nice new layout. Yeah. And today we're doing India inks. So right now, working on a portrait. Sketching for now. I haven't drawn people in forever, so hopefully it'll go okay. Hope you're doing well. I guess it's afternoon for you, yeah. West Coast here. Okay, so now that I have the base sketched down, I'm gonna refine some lines with my mechanical. Hello? Doing a test right now. Okay, because it's fucking odor. Still having issues with this Bluetooth mic. Working on it. Yeah, it's such a blind, they're just about done. I kind of want to refine the details of the hair a bit more before I start inking. Okay, I think I can start inking now. So I'm gonna erase some of the darker pencil lines that I did and then go and start inking. Okay. Grays are down. So I'm just gonna do some touch-ups with white gel. Add some highlights, maybe fill in any speckles that got splattered. Okay, so I think this illustration is done. Ow! Wanted to zoom out. Yeah, so this is just on a 8.5x11 piece of cardstock. I think it looks really nice on camera, like the grays came out really well. I kind of don't like the streakies here, but once it's fully dry, it should be a little less streaky. I think if I would use a larger brush, lot more coverage would have allowed for less truck marks, but that's okay. Yeah, I honestly really like how the hands came out. I personally really like drawing hands. This hand does look a little bit big. That's fine, because it looks like the sleeve is a bit higher on that wrist. Let's go ahead and zoom in for a little bit more details. I don't know if she'll focus. It's not gonna, that's okay though. Close up on the eyes. I really like the detail of the hand. Like the shapes are really good. This is how they looked in the ref, like the little squished of fingers. But these two came out really nice. Just like this crop like this would look really pretty. I think it looks interesting with just like the lighter streaks on like the right side. Yeah, that's the final. I kind of definitely, this is really fun. I haven't drawn people in ages, but it's fun to do again. Like, I know it's not fully accurate. Like, if we look at the ref, it's not like a totally accurate rendering. Because, like, I made this face a little bit longer. But I definitely made the eyes, like, wider. But I still really like how it came out. Yeah, I think this week I kind of just want to do portraits because this was honestly really fun. Yeah. So I think we're going to end it here today. Getting kind of hungry, so probably going to make some lunch. Yeah, so I'll be back tomorrow. 10 a.m. PST, unless something happens again. But y'all should know. I usually will post on IG or Twitter if I'm not going to stream like yesterday. But yeah, I actually went to Michael's yesterday because we went to the hair salon and I got a trim. And then they told me what products to use because I have really curly hair. And we went to Michael's afterwards and like the clearance section had some really nice gems. Like, you know, the plasticky ones. Like, I have an idea of what I want to do with them because I kind of want to make earrings again. Like, right now I'm like sketching out different designs and concepts that I can try and render. Yeah, so maybe next week or the following week, depending on if I get tired of these ink portraits or not. Honestly, I'm looking at it because like the camera angle, it squashes the face. I like kind of like how it looks a bit more exaggerated than like my final render looks a bit more stretched out. But from a distance, it looks pretty solid. Definitely this eye's really big, but I kind of like how that one looks a bit more exaggerated. I'm looking at a mirror that's across my room for now. Yeah. Anyway, so I got hella gems. I also got more acrylics. I got some materials for stamp carving. I got some block ink. Because, like, I don't go out much. So I'd rather get, like, all that I want now while I have some spending money. And then that way when I want to do the project, I have the stuff. Probably later today, I'm gonna like rearrange my room a bit and find places to put all the stuff I got. Anyway, a little bit of, I know I don't talk much. I'm still having issues with the mic. So like I'll only unmute when I want to say something because there's an issue with it picking up static and I'm trying to troubleshoot it. But hopefully it'll be fixed soon. Yeah, okay. Well, I'm gonna call it a day. Be back tomorrow. AMPST. Okay, bye.